Good day, everybody. In this video, I'm going to explain how we can use analyze data from triaxial test or any other strength test, and we can estimate different parameters of intact rocks and also rock mass. So we're gonna use the software which is called RSData. It's from Rocscience. Before there used to be a slightly different software called RockData, but I think they did some like major update. So now it looks very, it's a different one. And we're gonna use some examples when we have data from triaxial tests, and we're gonna analyze it, and then we can apply it to the rock mass. So we're gonna start the software, and we're gonna choose a rock template, select it and click OK. So the next step is, you see here we have rock template, so this is what we're going to use. We're going to go and click state one. And then you see here there is option for triaxial tests. So we have also direct shear test, but what we do is we're going to use triaxial test. And we're going to input data from triaxial test. So this is something that we can obtain from a laboratory test. So I already have this data, and I'm just gonna add a few more rows and put the numbers. So for the first test, we have here principal stresses. So sigma 3, it's minor principal stress. Sigma 1 is major principal stress. So for the first test, data update was sigma 3 was 0. Maximum principal stress, sigma 1 was 78. So for the second test, we got 5, and that the value obtained 124.5. So that's for the second test. Let's add a little bit of more. For the third one, the sigma 3 confining pressure was 10 MPa, and then when we apply stress to failure, it was 145.5. Then there was another set of data with the initial sigma 3 was 20 MPa, and the principal stress at failure was 196. Let's get one more row. So for the fourth test, the confining pressure was 30 MPa, and the stress at failure was 230.5. And for the final test, so altogether five tests, the confining pressure sigma 3 was 40 MPa, when the stress at failure was 262.5. Okay. So these are the data from the triaxial test. So we'll put them in here. So that will show you the points, data here, and this is the curve. So what we need to do next is we are gonna do calibration. So to do calibration, we're gonna click on rock template, right click on rock template, and you'll see there's a menu, just choose apply calibration. And then we can apply calibration here. So for this calibration, we choose, we select calibration. So once we select calibration, you see that we can go with a different failure criteria. There is here generalized Hoek-Brown. We can do also more Coulomb. So what we do is we're just gonna go with generalized Hoek-Brown. And here, curve fit analysis, there are a few options. So I'm gonna go with linear regression. There was a video that I made a few months ago where I actually explained this example using Excel spreadsheet. So you can probably look at that video. I'm gonna put a link to that video in this video description so that it's gonna be the same answer as I explained in that video. Of course, you can go with a different, you can go with a modified cuckoo or any other type of analysis. If you change the type of analysis, this curve fit parameters, yes, your values will be different, but not by much. So here I'm going with linear regression. Here I will choose vertical, and here it will be absolute. So now this is the data here on the right-hand side. You see that UCS, which is unconfined compressive strength of this rock, will be estimated as 88.5 MPa. And this value of MI, it's around 12. So this value MI, they are different for different rocks. I will show you later where you can find these values for different geology, right? So disturbance factor, this is something that I will discuss a little bit later when we actually apply data to rock mass. So we will need to know how disturbed the rock mass is. So let's continue this example. So that will be the answer for the first question. So this is the analysis. Let's look at the example when we actually want to use this data and apply it to rock mass. And what we know about this rock mass is that geological strength index of this rock mass is 75. So it's a kind of a blocky structure of the rock mass. And the application will be for slopes, right? And the height of the slope will be about 40 meters. So when we're going to excavate it or any other ways that we're going to work with this slope, the mechanical excavation will have a minimum disturbance, right? So what we need to do now, we're going to apply this data that we obtained for very, very small intact sample to the rock mass, and then see what will be the unconfined compressive strength of the rock mass, and also tensile strength and other parameters like cohesion friction angle. What I didn't mention here, rock mass parameters, you also see tensile strength. So this tensile strength, it's for this just like rock sample. So it's a small sample. This unconfined compressive strength, 88.5, it's also for rock sample. How do we know that? Because here, GSI, which stands for geological strength index, is 100. So 100 means there is no cracks, no discontinuities, and that will always go with intact samples. You'll see we're going to change it later, and these values will also change. Okay, so now let's see how we can do it. We are going to option which is called materials and define material models. And here you have a few options. So you see that this number, 88.5 that we obtain, is grayed out. So this means that you cannot change it, right? So these values like GSI, capital D, we can change it. And this is what we're going to use to apply to the rock mass. So as already said, the example that we're dealing with, this geological strength index, it's 75. So we can actually change it to 75. Or if you don't know the number, what you can do is you can click on this table. And then here you see this geological strength index chart. And based on the description that you have, maybe from the site investigation, you can decide what the number is going to be, right? So if you see that the rock mass, it looks like a blocky because it has only three discontinuity sets and surface conditions are good. So in this case, maybe the number will be 65, right? So what we have, we already know that it's 75. I'm going to change here to 75 and click OK. This is just the number which is given in this example. So this one is MI. We cannot really change it because that comes from the triaxial test. But there is always an option if you don't know MI and doing some estimations. So there is a table here based on the geology of the rock, like basalt, that will give you a value of 25 MI. But we're not going to change it because we already have laboratory data that we're going to use. So this one value of disturbance, so this capital D, We're going to click here. So you have two applications, tunnels and slopes. The one that we deal with is slopes. And then what we know is going to be a mechanical minimum disturbance. So we're going to look for the option here. Basically, you have two options, 0.7 and 1. So the higher the value means the like much more disturbance. So in our case, we're going to go with, unless we find something, probably we're going to with this good blasting. So the value will be 0.7. So click OK. OK, so another information that we have is that its slope height is 40 meters. So we're going to use this tab, which is called failure range. And then it gives you options with applications. So generally, just kind of like general, you don't really know what you're dealing with. If you click here, you're going to have tunnels or slopes. So we're going to go with slopes. And then it asks you for some information. So this is the unit weight, which correlates to 27 kilonewton per cubic meters, which is the average unit weight of rock. If you have any data, more specific data from either laboratory test or site investigation, you change it here. So we don't have this information. We're just going to go with the average value. We're not going to change it. Slope height, in the example we're dealing with, the slope height is given as 40. So I'm going to click 40. This one you don't need to change, number of points. You can look here at the stiffness. So this is a little bit more information. If you want to change something, you can do that here. But for this example, we're not going to do anything, not change anything here. And I'm going to click OK. So you see how all the numbers will change. Tensile strength will drop. I think before it was about probably, I don't remember, maybe 10 or 11 MPa. So it dropped to 0.7, right? So here also you see that unconfined compressive strength of the rock mass also dropped to 14, right? So these are the numbers that are going to be very helpful when you apply this data to rock mass. You see why it changed? So here is still the same. So it says intact rock. So this is intact rock. So this is the data that we get from triaxial test. It will remain the same. But here we change this geological strength index to 75. And because of that, all these numbers are changed, right? And also you see that now it's called rock mass parameter. So these values actually apply to a rock mass. Okay, so that's how you do it.